Hello, everyone. How are we doing today? I hope our Friday has gone well. Hi, Power. How are you? Don't mind me. I'm just quickly evolving some of my flowettes and stuff. Ooh, shiny Aracuda plush. There we go. Shiny stone. Doing good? I'm glad to hear it. So I'm loving this outbreak event with the Floettes because I literally need a orange and a yellow to have their entire lines completely shiny for every single flower. I'm doing well. Had work today, wasn't too awful. I'm excited to actually get into the second part of the DLC story. I'm a little upset to hear that a lot of those legendaries are going to be shiny locked. Like, not counting the new ones, I mean like returning legendaries too. They're shiny locked supposedly. And I'm like, ah, great. So we're still gonna have to hunt a lot of the legendaries in Scarlet, or not Scarlet and Violet, crap. Sword and Shield. I need... Archer, how you doing today? Where? God. You. Eat two of those. Have you started the DLC? We have done the first DLC. We are starting the second DLC, like, as soon as I'm done with this evolution stuff. Because sadly, Scarlet does not have either of the two colors available for shiny hunting today for me. Hey, there's a boa with a crocodile. Let's go.
Hello, motherfucker.
Crocodile, yes. Still reading Swerve, but otherwise pretty good. Yeah, you get to see the DLC from the beginning. Yes, Power, you do. Like I said, I'm just evolving these guys real quick and moving them into home, and then we'll get started. All right, so we're gonna save that real quick. Wait, I gotta put that one in the box. Hold up. A mistake was made. So yes, I need a yellow and an orange, and I will have the entire Floette line, all color variations, shiny, done. Okay, now save. We're gonna rotate to home real quick, and then we'll get into this. That's why I saved right here, so we can go right into the DLC. So, 2 secs. Uppies, please? Yeah, I can do Uppies power. Where do you want to be pinned at? So I know where I'm pinning you. Where are you at? There you are. Do you want to be on my head? No. How about shoulder? Shoulder for now. And there we go. You get to be up there until you fall in, like, 3 minutes. Freaking, okay, so they had home down for like 48 hours due to the update, and oh my goodness. I was like, I'm trying to see what colors I need to hunt still. Because I move everything into home so I can see it all, because I'm going obviously between both games. And because I've got the physical copies, I'm like, okay, I can't just, you know, flip-flop. Okay, so now, boop. You for you. You for you. You're on the other page. Okay, so I need 8 orange. Archer, thank you for the resubscribe. I appreciate it. And then you. You were the other one. God, it's almost been a year, man. Sane to think about. Mass bomb. There we go. So yes, we have all the Flobebe shiny. We have all the Floette shiny. We just need an extra yellow and an extra orange to finish the Floregus. Which is very nice to see. Having to hunt 2 is not that bad. Having to hunt 15 is a problem. I'm hoping I can take advantage of the Milcery too. Because I think I have until the 21st for these mass outbreaks. Alright, cool. Now DLC time. This is why I was a little late. I was trying to finish this all up and everything's like, we still have to update. Archer almost had the start, but then you got launched into it. Wait, why 15? Because there's 5 different colors of Floettes and there's 3 different stages to the revolutionary line. Or not Floettes, Flobebes. So you have to have one of each color for the shiny living decks. The Milceries I'll need at least 8 of. I'm not doing all 63 variations. We're doing the treat variation list. I do not need to have to catch 64 shiny Milceries. Why not? Because I'm insane, but I'm not that insane, okay? We'll start with 8. And the other reason I say I need like 10 is because I know I'm gonna mess up the spin times on some of those. Catch infinite shiny Spinda, yeah, where everyone has its slightly own different pattern. Alright, so the only thing we missed with the DLC is the phone call that starts it off. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. But basically, Clavicle calls you and says, come to my office. That's the gist of the phone call. Who do we have here? Who are you? I know I've seen your face somewhere before. Who were you again? Wolf? That's who we are? Wolf's crazy in a different manner, yes. Oh, that's right. You're Wolf. Yes, yes, I do know you. Well, now then. Now that you're here, let's get going. Wait, just a minute. Sayano? Is that how they want us to say it? Oh, hello there, Ellie? Veli. You're as lively as always. Didn't realize you were here. It's his school! Thank you for the hug. Of course I'm here. As director of this academy, where else would I be? And do address me more properly while students are present, would you? I feel like these two went to school together. More importantly, what are you doing out here? I thought we had agreed to meet in my office. Did we? Must have slipped my mind. Anyway, what's it matter? This is the student, right? Well, yes, she is, but... I do apologize, Miss Wolf. You must be terribly confused. This is Director Cyrano of Blueberry Academy. As I mentioned on the phone, he's interested in accepting you as an exchange student. Yep, that's me. Or did I not mention that? He looks like he's about to make you an offer you can't refuse. Yes. He's also slightly cross-eyed. One look at a young friend here makes me suspect you indeed failed to clarify that point. Speaking of which, why did you request Miss Wolf specifically to take part in your exchange program? Excellent question, Veli. It's very simple. You see, the reason is... Bald. Why did I put on that? This dude is so forgetful. How do you run a school? Oh, that's right, the school trip to Kitakami. Wolf met some of my students there, didn't she? Yes. Yes, yes. One of them was named Carmine, I believe. She's the one who recommended you. Now that I've gotten to meet you for myself, yeah, I've got a good feeling about you. Oh, I'm glad to hear that. I'd just love if you would visit my school. You would be a breath of fresh air, so to speak. Well, if anything can be said about Director Cyrano. I'm gonna keep tripping over his name, and I don't know why. Is that he has a keen eye for talent. I'd be thrilled if you went to Blueberry Academy and got to know the students there. But only if you're willing to do so, of course. I mean, I paid the money, didn't I? Think of this as a chance to further expand upon your personal treasure hunt. I wish I could accompany Miss Wolf, but I'm afraid I must ask you to watch over her in my stead. You will watch over her, won't you? Oh, of course! I'd never let anything happen to one of your students. Why do I feel like we're gonna end up in the deepest, darkest pit right now? I hope this experience leads you to something even more you can treasure. Best of luck to you! I will point out, it has been really hard to avoid any spoilers when it comes to this freaking second DLC, man. Just give me a haul whenever you're ready to head to Blueberry Academy. Dude, why do you think I'm here? Are you ready to kick off your studies abroad at Blueberry? Yes. Great, then let's get going. Like how they're just like, you're running around in the Kitakami outfit, but we can't be bothered to make you change back into your school uniform. Hey, a Dragonite's flying past the plane. Oh God. I just realized airplanes in the Pokemon world mean that there's... Remember, Building Dragon and Candy Apple Dragon have new evolutions? Yes. But I just realized that, How do bird like strikes work in the world of Pokemon? Because there's obviously planes. What happens if you're just flying along at Mach Jeebus and you hit a freaking Dragonite? I'm assuming the plane crashes and everyone dies. Ta-da, we're here. Welcome to my grand Blueberry Academy. It's giving iceberg vibe. This is actually just the entrance. The school itself is mostly underwater. Isn't that amazing? Oh, and did you notice? Look at how blue the place is. I can't tell you how long I spent picking the perfect blueberry color. Oh my god, this dude's on the nose with this, ain't he? The plane crashes and everyone turns into a wolf. Oh god. Let's see, what else? Perhaps you'd like to ask me? Why is it mostly underwater? Why can't you be part of Unova proper? Really? That's what you're curious about? Well, it's very simple, you see. It's because the school building is attached to an undersea plant that develops its natural resources. Welcome to the Unova, yep. Right? That's what I've heard. Right, yes, exactly. You took the words right out of my mouth. Anyway, always on point, aren't you, Lacey? Your hair. Also, her hair ornaments are pretty. Oh no, it was nothing. Do we have a guest today? We do. Wolf here is part of the exchange program. Make her feel welcome, huh? Hold on, this is the exchange student from the Paldea region. I suppose I didn't introduce myself, did I? I'm Lacey, one of the second year students here. You must really be something special, you know? It's rare for Director Cyano to remember the name of a new student. Just call me out, why don't you? Actually, I've got an idea. Why don't you explain how things work around here, Lacey? Again, how is this man a director of a school? You want me to do it? Well, yeah, you know this tour guide stuff isn't my strong suit. Well, that's certainly true, but still, I imagine there must be someone more suitable than me. Oh, please don't take it like that. It's not like I don't want to show you around or anything. Director Cyano just has this bad habit of pushing his duties onto me, you see? You're a student! And it's just not right. Thank you. Really letting me have it today, aren't you? That said, it might be my chance to get to know the new student everyone's talking about before anyone else can. Is anything his strong suit? I have no idea. That decides it, I will take on this task. Excellent. Now then, let's head straight to this bridge and on. Yeah, straight down this bridge and to the entrance. On you go. Right. I have a funny feeling we're about to get jumped, so I'm gonna keep the Kitakami team. It's just most of them are now level 100. We're gonna keep the Mew in the party for now. This is what I get for having to run around and power level things. Dude has a Magmar. Dude, I'm excited to shiny hunt Chikorita in this game. Finally, my baby back. This is the entrance to Blueberry Academy. They have a battle field like right at the entrance. Interesting. Our school puts a great deal of emphasis on the art of Pokemon battling. We hold official matches on the central court right here at the entrance, and any student can freely utilize this court if it's not otherwise in use. I think it's safe to say that you'll be battling more here than any other school. Have you met Nimona? Believe me. Exactly, couldn't have said it better myself. Dr. Cyano, I think perhaps it's fine if you just leave the tour to me. Still, it's really relaxing here with the sea breeze blowing over you. Even when no one is battling, you often see students lazing about in the stands. Nimona is my favorite rival. I like Nimona as a rival. She's a little gung-ho, but eh. I feel like Nimona's rival fights are more challenging than the champion fight in this game, that's for sure. Oh, and there's this other quality of our school that you'll find very surprising. Wild Pokemon sometimes terrastalize here. Huh. Oh, I suppose that's not anything special to someone from Paldea, is it? The terrestrial... And in Silver, your favorites? Dude, I like N. Silver, I felt like was a cocky brat, but after dealing with Gary slash Blue so many times, I was just kind of like, yeah, Silver's not as cocky. Although I do like N as a rival. The terrestrial phenomenon was first discovered in the Paldea region, after all. But we've taken things a step further than you and your Terra Orbs. We've developed some neat tech ourselves, something that lets us control the terrestrial phenomenon on our own turf. So are you saying I don't have... Wait. But the whole point of the orb was so you only had one Pokemon per battle who could terrestrialize. If y'all can control it at will because of your tech, as long as you're on a field that's supported by the tech, does that mean any Pokemon can terrestrialize? Like, you terrestrialize your whole team? Yeah, I guess that pikes my interest. Like, I'm not a fan of the mechanic. Sir, I think it will be easier to understand how this works when we go to the lower level. Could you put a pin in that thought? Always thinking ahead. That's our lazy. Gary, mother effing Oak, smell you later, loser. Yelp. Oh, you know what? I think it'd be great if you two had a battle. What? Right now? Why not? I'd like to see what Wolf here is capable of. Our Lacey is the member of the Elite Four in the League Club we have going here. To say nothing of the influence of her father, one of the Unova region's famed gym leaders. And now I gotta see her and think of the gym leaders. Who's your dad? I bet you'll learn a thing or two. I wish you wouldn't go spreading personal information around without asking first. It's just not right. Give me a good show, you two. Oh, God. I'm sorry, but there's no negotiating with Director Sayano once he gets an idea in his head. There's no way that he'll be move on with the tour until we've given him this battle. Besides, I'll have to admit, I'm a little excited for the chance for me to battle you. Here at Blueberry Academy, we tend to go for double battles. Oh, okay. Interesting, because the only gym leader in Paldea who did double battles was Rhyme, the ghost gym leader. So do you have a type specialty or not? Oh God, these two. It was because of their character development that they had throughout the games. I prefer the remake Silver because of the extra development they got. Fair enough, Power. I suppose I'm representing Blueberry Academy in this. Well, incidentally, I have two really good mons for this. I didn't realize I had them up front though. I'm gonna be an ass. Wait, you're not a flying type, are you? You're not a flying type, crap. Okay. I almost did something dumb. Death to the Pika clones. We're working on it. Luckily, these things are not known for their kill them faster. I'm working on it. I can't use Earthquake because Volcarona will get hit by it. That's gonna hurt. Also, why do you know Grass Knot? Hey, Volcarona broke the paralysis. Good. Right, you killed that one. And I'm gonna be a dick. Gets the crit. That was quite the harsh blow. Tell Volcarona to do better. Power, Volcarona's trying, alright? Leave Mothra alone. I like how Mew's just in the back cheering everybody on. Stop at the Grass Knot. Time to go one for pure strength. Excadrill. Yeah, you break the mold. Butterfree is a better Mothra. It is a better Mothra, but Volcarona is a female and it has the thing for hatching eggs faster. You were gonna swap out of. Ah, crap, I forgot I had Roaring Moon in the party. I need to get that Roaring Moon out of the party. That's not supposed to be there. That's what's supposed to be my Kamo. Because it's only level 66. It's supposed to be the Kamo that I trained up. I've been clearing so many of the outbreaks. I just had a bunch of Pokemon in the party to farm XP for them so I could raise their levels without using the items. I don't like using rare candies if I don't have to, put it that way. Because I have a bunch of Pokemon that are in the 50s, but I knew this DLC was going to be higher. This Plusle is still alive, and it's irritating the crap out of me that it's still alive. I'm just going to try to burn this thing to death. I mean, it worked. I don't mind the Mew. I just can't have two mascots. You beat me soundly.
Yeah, about that.
Toy what? I wish I could have seen you Trostwise one of your Pokemon, though. Listen, I very rarely. The students here at Blueberry Academy were only recently issued Terra Orbs. You mean this. Yeah. You're fine, Power. Well done, the both of you. You really battled out in Blueberry style. Speaking of style, I forgot. I had a uniform for you. You'll feel like you fit right in as soon as you're dressing the part. She's not wearing a uniform, though. Why do I gotta wear a uniform? Damn it. I was free. I was free of the uniforms. It's a sailor outfit. Oh, okay, she is wearing it. She just has an overcoat. That's what I call fashion. Oh, and you can take this as well. Indigo style card. Having one of these increases the selection available to boutiques and hair salons. Why don't we head into the school? You can pick where you want to go from the gates over there. Come on, I'll show you the pride of the Blueberry Academy, our world-famous terrarium. One sec. You have to work because the game says you have to. I know, but still. They gave us freedom and now we no longer have it. Do I want you or do I want the Mighty Anna? Probably you. Because Mighty Anna is the other one that we were running around Kitsukami with. Tachik! Anyway. Where do you want to go? Well, I only have one option, so I guess that's where we're going. I just want a shiny hunt Chikorita in this game. I just want a shiny hunt Chikorita. This gives off aquarium vibes so freaking hard right now. That certainly is not an aquarium, though. At least they gave me a bag to match the outfit, I guess. Like how you guys are both being Christmassy. Ooh, I'm excited. Tomorrow morning we're gonna go to the Christmas markets. Never been to one. Excited. This is it. The park beneath the sea that has gained renown around the world. I mean, this is the first time I'm hearing of it. Our very own terrarium. We may be underwater, but the project projectors built into the walls and ceiling make it feel like we're actually outside, don't they? We've been able to create a comfortable environment for Pokemon through technology. Do I see a Hisuian Growlithe in the distance? I designed all this myself, and believe me, it wasn't cheap. Within this dome, there are four distinct biomes. Here we have the nice and toasty subtropical savanna biome. You will wear the uniform, you will like it. No! Then off to your right, you can see the breezy tropical coastal biome. Further to your out to your left, you'll see the craggy, crunchy, rugged canyon biome. And last but not least, way out in the distance, we have the Arctic and snowy polar biome. Each biome's air temperature and humidity levels are regulated with the utmost of care. That's why you can find completely different Pokemon species living within each area. You don't get an option, I noticed. We sure put a lot of effort into it. Tell me, Wolf, which biome tickles your fancy off the bat? Send me to the canyons. You can also find a mysterious ore in that biome we call Charge Stone. If you need to heal up your team while you're out down here, feel free to use the self-service healing. That is a Hisuian Growlithe. Whichever has the most dragons. Oh, I have no idea on that one. I was trying to figure out which one was going to have Chikorita. Can you explain to us why crystals form here and how the terrestrial wild Pokemon are able to terrestrialize? But you know already, Lazy, that... Oh, I get it. You want me to do the talking. In that case, let me show you. The reason is actually right above our heads. What that? That there is the terrarium core, which presides over all that happens within the terrarium itself. It contains fluid that we've jam-packed full of special material from Paldea. You mean you liquidized the crystal? It's constantly emitting terrestrial energy. That's how Pokemon allows Pokemon to terrestrialize within the dome. They had switched biomes, so that was my answer. Fair enough, Power. Though I still don't know that special material is within the terrarium core itself. It's never been shared publicly, has it? Which, in the world of Pokemon, gives a sinister vibe to something. Oh, you want to know? Well, in fact, it's... He doesn't remember. Oh, was it? I've plumb forgotten. Briar put all of it together, so I'm not certain myself. That's what I thought you might say. Whichever one has the evolutions, fair enough. Practical battle class will commence shortly in the coastal biome. Students participating in the class should make their way to the coastal biome now. Oh, I should have read that in the creepy customer service voice. That would have been better. Oh, it looks like you're just in time to see a class session too. This is too good for a chance to pass up. You will be joining us, Wolf, won't you? You can get your first taste of our school's classes. I guess. I will state this. Unlike the Scarlet playthrough where we completely ignored the class's existence because they had no real bearing on the story progression, we are going to do the classes as they pop up this time. I'd love to see that sort of passion for education. And that's just because we are exchange students. I don't know if they're going to force the classes or not. Just give me the entire Blueberry Academy map. It's fun to take a soul through the terrarium on your own. I think it'd be more of a hassle, if anything, if you had me holding your hand. So, yep, that settles it. Please find your way to the class site of the coastal biome on your own. Ooh, rough light in chat. Well, it doesn't seem like I'm needed here. Wait, sir, you don't... But I've made sure that a dorm room has been all set up for you, Wolf, so don't forget to give it a visit later. Oh yes, one other thing. Could you open your Pokedex app for me? Gibdex. The Blueberry Pokedex has been added to your Pokedex app. You know, if not Niantic, they develop Pokemon Go. If Game Freak and Nintendo wanted to have fun, they'd have an actual Pokemon app you could physically download. Not home or anything, but like just an actual app you could sync to the game. And there he goes. Some people would like her to hold their hand the whole way. Yeah, I'm good. You can at least count on me to be around when you need me, so there's no call for concern. There's probably time we both head to class. I'll be waiting for you to join us in the coastal biome. Time to disappear for the next 6 hours. Hey, guys, anyone see the new exchange student? Foaming at the mouth. Because we're in the polar biome. Oh! It's Adamant's descendant, the one from Kitsukami that we had to do the photos for. What legend do you have for us now? Because last time it was Blood Moon Ursaluna. Panin! A familiar face. Hold up. What do you want from us?
It's a boy! Gwah.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't I know you from somewhere? That's right, my old partner. How are you, partner? I mean, Wolf. Perrin! That's right, good old Perrin is here still kicking it. You doing well yourself? I sure appreciate all the help you gave me back at Kitsukami tracking down the Blood Moon Beast. I never thought I'd bump into you like this. How about I teach you a new pose to celebrate? Steals the Growlithe. Looking good emote. Oh, but what about that Growlithe I entrusted you? Is he... Ah. Growl. I forgot. His brother. I'll have to see if he's still in my box. Nice, you're here as some sort of exchange student, huh? Nice. What a coincidence. I just started working here. As a photographer, of course. Cool. Pretty much. Though I'm still sort of waiting to hear if the school likes my work, to be fair. Oh, that's always nerve-wracking. They say they want snapshots of the terrarium and the students for all the upcoming marketing stuff. So, how about some photos? Speaking of photos, I've got a hot tip I could let you in on. But if I told you, I bet you'd just go running right off. Damn it! Knows me too well. How about this? I'll snap some candid shots of you catching tons of Pokemon within the terrarium. Don't worry, you won't even notice I'm nearby. If I make enough headway, I'll, in my work by the time you're registered, say 200 Pokemon in the Dex. I probably did ship him off to home. I'll have to check. I'll share that hot tip. So we need 200 in the Blueberry Dex, huh? We'll check real quick. Because obviously that is Pele, poor pupper. I mean, to be fair, he's safer in home than he is in the boxes in the game. I was like waiting for the rest of the box to load. I'm like, wait, nope. Let's see. Because the last three boxes should be Kitakami. He's probably at home. Whoops! Wait, no, that was another Lore Vesta. I might have to check home. You monster. He is safer at home. I do have a tendency to mass release things just in my games if they're not stuff I want to keep. That's a regular Growlithe. That's another Arcanine. Hold up. I'll check home on my phone real quick. Because I can search it a little bit easier on my phone. If he's in home, I'll go get him, okay? Load. This is one thing I hate, is the fact that home just takes a little bit to connect to servers. So you know how I'm pretty far behind in Scarlet? Yeah, Boa, what's up? Pokemon. I gotta search. Orthorm, derogatory. You don't like Orthorm? Why not, Boa? Hold on one sec. Titan Orthorm. Ah. No Pokemon found my butt. Alright. Brief intermission while we save and go back into home and check. Also, my avatar's broken again. Hang on. We'll go rescue the pupper from home. The question becomes, does it have Perrin as the original one? Orthoworm is adorable. Okay, so you like Orthoworm, just not the Titan. That's valid. Titan Orthorm is being a pain. Ah, I understand. I know, home, you updated and now you're going to be slower than normal, but come on. Everyone's yelling at me to go save a pupper. Plays when he heals theme while Wolf saves the pupper. Hey, listen, there's like two boxes it could be in, all right? It's going to be real easy for me to check. Because I keep stuff sorted. Nothing there. All right, what am I doing? List view. Filter. GRA. I saw it. Wait, there it is. Arvin, we need fire, or not whatever Toad School is. I think Toad School is a ground type. Okay, so. That one's Mikey. This one. This is the one we need. It's in the game. I overlooked him. I overlooked him. He was in the game the entire time. He's in box 12. I overlooked him. Well, now I know where he is. He was never put in home. Why do I feel like Growlithe is playing hide and go seek right now? I don't want to know what he's watching behind me. Ah, Levy's munching on food. Plays a fail horn at the same time. It's fine, it's fine. We'll swap the Mew that is our current cheer to Growlithe. It just means at a certain point, though, we're gonna have to go ahead. Alright, give me. You go there. We steal the boy. I move the Wooper over just so the box is full, because otherwise it'll bother me. All right, we're good. We're good. Execute! Aha! I can write Karide on here. The Duo, Scyther, Venonat, Rhyhorn. Oh, right. Hold up. We've battled 88, and we've caught 82 of them already. Interesting. I wonder if you evolve. What do you mean? High pop. I can't remember what Throw Worm gives. I think it gives the jump. Execute Venonat. Savannah Biome. Execute if you get Cantonian or Alola. I know Alolan is an option. Like, we're supposed to be able to get all but like 10 Pokemon now in this game. Oh god. Please, please god, no. So much mud. Huh. Rhyhorn. Ow! Guys, the Rhyhorn assaulted me. You saw it. For the Dex. I don't care if I'm abusing Quake Ball status. It's for the Pokemon Dex. Also, levels for the pupper. Die! No! Send it to the box. Rhyhorn claims an area with over 6 miles radius as its territory. Apparently it forgets where the territory is when running, however. You know, I don't mind the gray blazer, but I still don't like the orange pants. Yeah, the pants are the biggest conundrum for me. It's mainly the color. 3 large experience candies. I don't know, Power. I'm assuming we'd figure it out at some point. So we got the Deerlings back. Oh, I see a Trapinch! Flygon's back, baby! Smeargle! They brought back Smeargle finally, guys. Yes! Hey, speaking of, there's the Cantonian Executor. Hapini. Of course he's being assumed right. He doesn't know anything else. Magby, Magmar. Rhydon. So I'm gonna, like, we're gonna ignore the fact that we're supposed to go to class for just a minute so I can explore. Peachberry. Experience candies. Darlings! I still have to get the rest of you guys shiny. I've only got one so far. The fuck is this shit? The fuck is this crap? Lorelei's, what the hell? What are all these items? Savannah Plaza. Why are there so many fire terror shards? What the hell? Are these just like, oh, is this like the battle area for the Elite Four dudes? Four biomes, four Elite Four members? For Brava! I ran into it. Like how it's just the horde watching. What's happening to Jim? Oh god, Jim's in a ball! Jim's being kidnapped for the sake of science. Vibrava, rather than using its underdeveloped wings for flight, it rubs them together, emitting ultrasonic waves to attack its enemies. Rather than use it for flight, then what are the other ones doing? Because that sure looks like flying to me. Soshbuck? More experience candy, good lord. Schmeargle. So you admit you were kidnapping Pokemon. I will eventually release them. Repeat Ball, Leapaberry. Leapaberry. Schmeargle, Trapinch for Brava. Protector, okay. So. Rhyperior then. Sawsbuck, Trapinch for Brava, Vibrava. Flygon! Come here! I'm sorry. Flygon's one of my favorite dragons. Damn it! Of course you want to fight. I don't know if you live. You should live a move from me. I was not correct on that. At least the Pokemon in my Totem Pokemon run was bred before the run, so I didn't kidnap them. I mean, you bred them in captivity, though. Like, I want to point that out. Schmeargles, Trapinches, Prism Berry, Deerlings, Deerlings, Chanseys. Execute Shell. Rock Terra Shards, Ross Berries. That's another Trapinch. I didn't ranch it did. Leave a berry. Max Ether.
Pretty Feather.
Doduo Down. Spearberry. Litleo. Pretty Feather. Peachberry. Sawsbuck. Oh, so is like this a hard dividing wall for the biomes? It is! Okay. That makes sense. Also, this game and the sparklies on the ground feed the kleptomania way too well. Or is it just the adventure hoarding? The daycare place you get the eggs from. Ah. I see. You didn't breed them. Also, that's an Alolan Geodude. Yeah, that's the Alolan Geodude. Hi, Scrafty. Tyrogue is threatening me, as it always does. I guess they just spawn both. Oh my god, all the items! My brain is just sitting here going, ooh, shiny, ooh, shiny, ooh, shiny, over and over and over again. This is why the little glowing sparkles on the ground's a problem. Alolan Graveler. If we see any of the Alolan Geodude line shiny, yell about them, because I need one more for my Alolan Geodude line to be complete. God, the shinies. Now, I don't know if starters spawn. I'm pretty sure we're gonna have to get to a certain part of the story for starters to spawn, because it seems like we're only getting a handful of Pokemon right now, which, valid. In Alolan games, you level the Pokemon in the Pokeplague where the daycare is only for breeding. Ah, okay. I'm not gonna lie, I saw this patch of grass next to where that Pokeball was, and I was like, what is that? Because I thought it was a Pokemon. Nope. Elekid. So all the babies are back. Poison jab. Scyther! Schmeargle. Let's do some addition. That doesn't sound like a proper Pokemon battle proposal, my sir. Schmeargle paint. Oh great, the Smeargles are gonna be chasing us. We stole their paint. They can no longer commit acts of graffiti. Jesus. What's up here? See, I told you they were gonna let me go and I was just gonna start running around. Tyrogue. Scyther again. I'm really glad I don't need any of the Scyther line anymore. Thank you, Legends Arceus. Meepa, Hurricane. Ah, it's a party up here. Scyther! All right, so now we yeet and glide until we plummet back to Earth. So that sounds about right for this game. Ooh, I spotted a cave. No, let me go to the cave. Damn it. Just let me infinitely glide, damn it. You won't let me regain altitude, so making me fall like a stone randomly is not the help. Flying Terra. Horsey! Horsey's back. Theoretically, I should be catching one of everything, but at the same time, I'm just kind of like, I want to run around and see what all there is first. Nuggies! I choose you. I see a lantern. Or is that a Chinchou? But still, Gen 2 Pokemon. Get in the ball, baby. It's a Chinchou. Yes! I will say, if you guys want me to continue the story, i.e. go to class, yell at me and I will go to class. Tyrogue, the scuffle Pokemon. This earnest Pokemon battles all sorts of opponents, searching for the fighting style that it suits best. Dink! I'm a little sad to see a Mololola back. Like, I know it has to come back, but it's one of those banes of my existence Pokemon. Also, why didn't we take the opportunity of Lugnasic evolution into a Mololola? Why are they both single stages still to this day? Horsey, the dragon Pokemon. If attacked by even a larger enemy, Horsey will effortlessly swim to safety by utilizing its well-developed dorsal fin. Ding! Of course it's Horsey Ink. Give me the sparkle. Let me run into this giant monstrosity. Just get in the quick ball and stay. It makes our lives easier. Thank you. Critical capture. Bless you. Amola-Ola, the caring Pokemon. It gently holds injured and weak Pokemon in its fins. Its special membrane heals their wounds. It's just the Chansey of the Sea. Got it, Seadra.
Fight me.
Prove your worth. Get in the ball and stay.
No!
Ooh, you actually have Dragon Dance? Hello? Speed Rose. I'm gonna go for the Leech Life. Hopefully that doesn't kill you. Yay! When you're having to resort to your weakest move in your move pool to not murder things on sight. Ow. Get in the ball. See? It's that easy. Seadra, the male raises the young. If it's approached while caring for young, it will use its toxic spines to fend off the intruder. Give me the Chinchou, and then I want the item. Yes, I'm always going to try the Quick Ball. To be fair, we only needed to catch, what, 108 Pokemon? Or is it 18? Chinchou, the angler Pokemon. It lives in the ocean depths beyond the reach of sunlight. It flashes the lights of its antennae to communicate with others of its kind. Why is it in the shallow pool, then? If it lives in the depths, then it means it would depressurize in shallower waters. Fun reason. Fun fact, that's the reason why things like the blobfish look the way they do up on the surface. They depressurize because their bodies are so adapted to the deep pressures of the ocean. So they always look funny when they're up here on the surface. They also frequently die on the surface because they need the pressure to live. They only perform under pressure. I'm not seeing any other interesting ones in the waters. Hey. Scrafty, I guess. Come here. Again, they will eventually be returned to their habitats, just not right this second. We need them for science. Come here, Scraggy. Scraggy, the shedding Pokemon. It stretches its saggy skin up to its neck to protect itself. Among Scraggy, individuals with saggier skin apparently garner more respect. Boink. Hello, Scyther. Did you have to assault me this early? Also, I get to run because I already have you caught. Deal with it. Ooh. I found a cave. Hey, there's a Rhydon. Terrestrializing Rhydon. Horsies, Chinchows, Amola-Olas, give me the pretty feather. Let's see, where we got Tyrogue, so many Hardstones, more Tyrogue. Gimme. Ooh, what is das? Focus Blast. Why do they always hide the Focus Blast TMs in random caves? Bad. My bad. Yeah, hi there. Sorry about that. Didn't mean to run into ya. Have a nice day. What else we got? I definitely feel like this is gonna be one of those ones, the more we progress the story, the more I found a mass outbreak of horsey. Ah, I see. That was not my intention. Come here. I feel like the more we progress the story, though, the more Pokemon we'll have spawning in the terrarium. That just feels like a good way of doing the mechanic. Oh, I was really hoping for the critical capture. Please stay. Thank you. Scrafty was caught. Scrafty, the hoodlum Pokemon. Groups of them beat up anything that enters their territory. Each can spit acidic liquid from its mouth. I don't know why does nosy wolves run into innocent Pokemon. I don't know. Because science? You can claim a reward, you've made progress within your decks. Hey, Hitmontop. I wonder if that means we can get Hitmonlee and Hitmonchan to punch. Although I guarantee you those two are gonna be split on versions. So do we murder the horsey? Or do we leave them be? Lantern! Fishy. Fishy, fish, fish. Aww. Is the only thing you have for me, Flip? Well. Please live the leech life and the burn damage. Nope. Never mind. Director still looks hilarious as Clive. Yes, he does. Oh, good. There's another lantern. Come here, more. Hopefully this one doesn't die as easily. Hopefully you're nice and you stay in the quick ball. Yeah, boy. Lantern was caught. Da, 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 da. Swirlix in chat. Lantern, the light Pokemon. Portions of its dorsal fin mutated, becoming the part that glows brightly to lure the prey. Also, this thing is almost 4 feet long and only weighs 50 pounds. Yeet the fish. It's like, hey, did you know you could claim a reward? And I'm just like, yes. Did you know I don't care? I don't think I have anyone who's gonna have the type advantage, so... Volcarona, do murder. Listen, we're here, we might as well. I'm only gonna do a little bit. Meow. Meow. Anywho. Ooh. There's a doohickey. Doohickey. Doohick. Doodad. There's a doodad. Then look at our careful steps. Me with the Karate on. Yeah, about that. What's gravity? I swear, half of anyone's instincts in a video game find the tallest point and climb it. Hello, Electabuzz. Oh god, the teacups are here too. Don't have to worry about them though. I know we've already cut those. Well, you guys all have Batangs. So, this is Steel-type city, isn't it? Hold up, what's with the vending machines? Wait, can I buy Pokeballs here? You can! Hello? Interesting. Oh god, you can buy everything here. Okay then. Hang on. Okay. We're not gonna question what I just did, okay? But interesting. So instead of Pokemarts, we have a vending machine now. Max and revive.
Pretty feather.
Magnemite. Give me the thing. Yeah. Scyther, why? Guys, can I set the Scyther on fire? We're setting the Scyther on fire. Burn. Okay, I feel slightly better now. Carbos times two. Interesting. So many float stones. Why so many float stones? Rarebon. Golette. Dive balls, I'll take those. Up. Come on, Groudon. You have the ability to climb. Please use it. Meteors! Hi, little dude! Get in the ball. Also, are they in their dormant state? Orange core. Follow the ground, try to return to space, but their wish will not come true. All they can do is fade away. That is a depressing Pokedex entry. Oh god, they're Calcifer. Are you also an orange core one? Yes, I'm gonna catch it just to see what its core is. See, this is the problem with letting me roam free, is the ooh shiny kicks in way too much. Are you also orange? Yes. Nope. Interesting. Ow! I'm pretty sure I've already caught you. Yeah, I know you, because you spawn outside of Lavincia, so I don't need you. The Golette I need. Sorry, Perrin gave me a challenge for 200, and I said bet, okay? You. You should be necessary. Yep, this is a baby at level 70. Why? Why are we like this? Elekid. It loves violent thunder. The space between its horns flicker bluish white when charging energy. Still not as depressing as the meteor. Or the miner. Yes, I know I can claim a prize. I don't care. We're doing things right now. That is a Kleavor running around. So, did they find the ancient forms of these Pokemon from Sinnoh, formerly known as Hisui, and revive them? Or how do they have Kleavor running around, is my point. Golette, the automation Pokemon. These Pokemon are thought to have been created by science of an ancient, mysterious civilization.
Think.
Star piece. Burp, 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 burp. Full restore, pretty feather. So we don't really want to keep heading north, I don't think. Hang on. I'm still low-key. Is that the Milcery outbreak?
Hold up.
Yes, it is. Awesome. Okay, well, we have to catch the first one regardless. The Pokedex beckons. Oh, do I have to move them all the way back into Sword and Shield in order to evolve them? Surely not. Like, surely they'll have a way of evolving them in this one. Because you can do the spin. So I'll have to find the items to evolve them elsewhere. Milcery, the cream Pokemon. The more sweet aromas it absorbs, the more its body swells. Milcery will deflate when its energy levels drop. No, we're not adding it to the party. Oh god, there's so many of them. Look, there's so many of them. I'm not used to them actually loading in this level for the outbreaks, good lord. Alright, well, do a murder. Have fun. Also, I have no idea what shiny Milcery even looks like. I'm going to assume because it's a pale Pokemon that it's just one of those ones that's like a shade or two different. So I'm not gonna really count on it being noticeable. But I can start hunting you guys now. Should I be distracted with this right now? Probably not. Should I have probably just gone straight to the class? Most definitely. Am I having fun? Yes. Yes, I am. Do murders, Mothra. We believe in you. Y'all two are tiny. Like, you were a good ways off, but you're also just tiny. Is white with gray eyes. That helps me not at all. I'm sorry, Boa. Thanks to this game's dynamic lighting, yeah. We'll see if I spot it, but that's if we get one to spawn without a sandwich. Because I'm just murdering right now. Also, I wonder if we're gonna have the issue of them spawning under the map again. Because I had that issue, like, yesterday. A bunch of my Flabébés were spawning in the wall. He is cool. Why did you go back into your Pokeball for that? Like, you can murder those two just fine. They definitely all like spawning over here, though. Damn. Well, Corona, just murder, honey. You've been released to do murders. Please do the murders. Okay. So I don't see any different colored ones right now. Here. Why not? Okay, that one's not as shiny as I got. That one looks pretty yellow to me, but. Time to curdle the cream. Man, Monday after work, I gotta make 3 cream cheesecakes. Also, if I'm getting Milcery cream from the sentient cream, does that mean I'm just ripping a chunk of essence off this Pokemon and collecting it for further use?
Okay.
Also, why do y'all move in a herd? This one's different! This one's different! Hey, there we go. You can tell. Cool! That's officially another new one for the decks!
Whoa!
I will check its summary. It doesn't have a mark, but I'll take her. Oh god. And now I'm gonna start bouncing from Milcery to Milcery. Whoops! Also, that's our first shiny of the DLC. It makes me happy. It's not the first full odd shiny, but it's the first shiny. So noted, you can tell the difference, which is good to know. Because like the Flabébés, they're so tiny, I can't tell when they're shiny or not. Murder that one. So many of you hiding up here. But I mean, I'll take one. Like how they're all just systematically coming up here to die. They have surrounded me. They've all literally came up here to surround me. I guess they didn't like me murdering one of their own. Or, well, a lot more than one, but still. Go back to murdering Mama Mothra. Oh, this one's like way down here by itself. There we go. I was like, hold up, that one's like way far away. Ooh, there's a Ludicolo in chat for anyone who wants to poke a catch. I will attempt to catch that.
Ludicolo, Ludicolo!
Not kidding about the number going down dramatically. I want to point out, I've murdered so many Flabébés, like trying to shiny hunt them during these outbreaks, that I've got max of their materials that they can drop. If only they were gimme ghouls. Oh, that's right, I still need to redeem the CU in Paldea for the special gimme ghoul. I promise we will get to the actual story of the DLC here in just a few minutes. I got distracted a lot. I just want to clear this outbreak. Where did you come from? You literally came out of the rock. You're gonna give me anxiety. No, the Ludicolo. Twofer, twofer. Let's go, I don't even have a sandwich up. I can't be mad at this, man. Let's go. Da-da-da-da. No, I don't want to give it a nickname. I do want to see if it has a mark, though. No. to the box. It's like, there's not many, I know. But listen, I need 8 of these suckers. I'm just glad that I can at least tell the difference on this shiny.
Murder!
We've also already almost cleared this outbreak, so I'm just gonna finish clearing it and then we'll continue on. Guys, guys! Number 3! 2 seconds later, number 3! Scarlet decided, hey, we're gonna outbreak pop off on these today. Which is good, because Flubaby was awful yesterday in this game. Let's go! Summary. Doesn't have a mark. That's fine. Yeah, those are really noticeable in that shiny. I'm glad. I was really afraid that it was gonna be like slightly a lighter shade type of thing. It's following me. Yeah, we're gonna go murder the outlier. Hopefully here and in a couple more knockouts, it should say that we've out dispersed the outbreak. We're not really getting a whole lot more to spawn, I notice. But man, there's 3 of like the 8 that I already need. That's amazing. I've currently got my newest team member decimating the Char Cadet population. Sounds about right. Char Cadet is a really hard shiny to spot. No. It is. Not. Okay, that's what I was like. Why are we circling it? I'm really disappointed with Char Cadet shiny. All they do is change the eyes to blue. Which I'm also really interested in the you play as your Pokemon thing that they got possibly going on in this game. I'm like, ooh. But fair warning, if you're doing that, I guess if you start a battle as your Pokemon, you can knock out shinies. So fair warning. Are you the last one I need to murder? Nope, there's still a few more. Damn it. They keep spawning. But I mean, I've gotten 3. I can't be mad. Scizor, why? Somebody gave me fire! Like, you see me using the Sobek Velarotar? Nice. Larvitar and Tyranitar are good Pokemon, man. I wish their shinies were a little bit more distinct. Like, Pupitar's got a really loud shiny. It's that freaking bright purple. But Larvitar is like a darker green, and then Tyranitar is kind of a darker green with the purple belly. Okay, the outbreak has officially dispersed, so it's just this last little wave. And I don't see another shiny in any of them. So we're just gonna knock you out for funsies. Because I'm rude like that. We must be thorough. I mean, I can't be mad though. I got almost half of what I needed for the Milceries. Who gave Wolf Fire this time? Volcarona, technically. Why do you chase me down? It's so weird, because you won't attack me, but you'll chase me. Freaking little weirdos. You have wings, you can get it. Yep, we're done. Okay, cool. It's not bad though, can't be mad. All right. Hey guys, we found the tundra. We're gonna go through every biome before we get to the coastal one because I went the opposite direction I was supposed to. I'm saving the battles for later in case it's kind of one of those things like you should battle as part of the storyline for enrichment purposes. Give me.
Seal! The little bubble!
Run into it, damn it. Also, I don't want Volcarona up front for this, but hey.
Quick ball, go!
Oh god, Finian's back. Why is Finian back? Seal, the sea lion Pokemon. The protrusion on its head is very hard. It is used for bashing through the thick ice.
Chubby little baby.
Oh my, look at the Lapras of the land. Is that Hisuian Quillfish? It is Hisuian Quillfish. Okay, I was like, what am I looking at? Watching the Lapras scoot across the snow-covered ground, man. Hello, sir. Get in the ball.
No!
Rude. You should live this.
About a half. You tanky. I like this.
The rain is already up, though. I have concerns.
No!
Unless it regains health, I can't use Leech Life again. It'll die. But you stay in a netball.
Yes, it will.
Lapras, the transport Pokemon. It ferries people across the sea on its back. It may sing an enchanting cry if it is in a good mood.
Doink!
They are judging me hard! Chuckles.
I'm in danger.
Hi, seals. Look at the seals. Porygon's back. I swear to God, if I find one of you guys purple randomly, I'm gonna friggin' scream. I have way. And now that's gonna be stuck in my head. Thank you, power. Mm-hmm. You brat. Of all the status conditions, you froze me. And then Volcarona said F you. You're welcome, Wolf. Oh, that Porygon died. What happened to him? It died. I'm not gonna lie, I like the battle music here. Alright, come here, Mincino. Whoop. Get in the ball, honey. Good rat. I know it's based off of chinchilla, alright, leave me alone. I'm still gonna call it a rat. It is a rodent in nature. Mincino, the chinchilla Pokemon. When its tail has gotten dirty from self-cleaning or from cleaning its nest, Mincino spends a whole day washing its tail in clean spring water. Doink! Where do we add to him, this Pokedex? Out of sheer curiosity. Battled 106, we've caught 98. We're almost halfway there, guys.
Cut you! Boop, boop.
Wait, I already have Kumchu. Crap. I wasn't thinking. And we critically got it. That's fine. Bum-ba-da-da. Also means we have Baratic, so I don't have to worry about that one. So basically, we're keeping an eye out for a Dewgong at this point. With Blueberry Academy being in Unova, it makes sense there would be a lot of Unova Pokemon here. Yes! Is that a Solas? I think that's a Solas chilling above the water. It is! This is not the biome I expected to find you, little dude. Get in the ball. And stay in the ball. There we go. I probably have to catch Finian and Lumion. Ow! Why am I being assaulted with a Pokeball? Solas, the cell Pokemon. Because their bodies are enveloped in a special liquid, they can survive within any environment. Ah, okay, that's why they're here. You said get the ball. Yeah! I'll check you real quick, because I don't think you were in the other two. Oh, you were. Okay, cool. I get to ignore you. Oh, right. I think you were in Kitakami. Listen, I've bounced back and forth the past couple weeks between this game, freaking Scarlet, Sword, Shield, and Arceus. I no longer remember who has what in which game. Hello, Duosun. Get in the ball. No! Wonder Room. Doesn't that turn off priority moves? So I thought you meant you wanted to get in the ball. Ah, I see. Oh wait, this is super effective, isn't it? Crap. Me forgetting that bug is super effective against Psychic. Whoopsies! Our Growlithe is like just power leveling though. The pupper's already level 40. I see a Dewgong. Hydrate. I can hydrate. Good sir, please get in the ball and stay. Hey, nose pass and chass. Maybe that will help your brain? Nah, not at all. We know this. Duosun, the mitosis Pokemon. Since they have divided two brains, at times they suddenly try to take two different actions at once. I don't know why we had to have Pokemon based off of frickin' cellular division, but you know. Alright, I guess check you. I don't know. Oh, okay, you do count as a different one. Right, because the white striped Basculin also counted as a different one for some inane reason. Probably because they're the ones that can evolve. So the question becomes, how the fudge do we evolve a Quillfish in this game? It is starting to have issues. Ooh, I didn't like that. All right, Dewgong. Dewgong! You're a little Dewgong. Man, so my first ever playthrough, like, don't get me wrong, I have like a slight hatred for Dewgong, not on design or anything. All I remember is the first time I played through Leaf Green and going through Seafoam Islands, I kept running into this Dewgong, like wild Dewgongs, and they kept freezing my team. Like, I hadn't had anything ever freeze me before. Every single time I found a Dewgong, I got frozen. I was like, God damn it. It sleeps under shallow ocean waters during the day and then looks for food at night when it is colder. So don't get me wrong, I like Dewgong, but I also have a slight hatred of them because, oh God. Also, that should officially put us beyond 100. So we're over halfway to Perrin's goal of 200. Do-do-do-do. Milceries. Stardust. I'm finding all the stuff to sell later on. Level up while knowing Barb Barrage. Ah, okay, that's not too bad. It's a lot easier than frickin' Legends Arceus, that's for snout, for sure. Hush. We know English is not my strong suit, even though it is my first language. Finian. Wee! I can write goods, I can't speak wells. What's in the cave? Chargestone Cavern. Wait. Joltik! Pup, we found the boy!
We found a puppy! He's so adorable!
Yeet! Yes! Bum ba da da. Joltik, the attaching Pokemon. Joltik that lives in the cities have learned a technique for sucking electricity out of the outlets in houses. I like how Boa immediately became shiny Joltik. It's a cool box art cover. Alright, well, we got an Excadrill and Drillbur. See, fun fact power. Basculegion was in the first DLC. We've already dealt with that one. I will have to do it again, though, when I get the extra shinies of the white line form, because I still need both male and female shiny Basculegion. I could probably bite you, and you would probably live. This may have been a bit... Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't think this is gonna go in my favor. I know it's not very effective, but I don't want to kill him, her, so... Yeah, so they had some of the... Like, if you did the Blood Moon Ursaluna quest, you went into that forest area, and so, like, you could go ahead and see some of the Hisuian Pokemon, and the whole thing was like, oh, they followed the Ursaluna here. Because that Ursaluna that you caught was, like, centuries old. Hi, Gurren Lagann Pokemon. I mean, you're not wrong. I still like that anime. Fuck that anime.
Thank you.
Excadrill, the subterranean Pokemon. Forming a drill with its steel claws and head, it can bore through a steel plate no matter how thick it is. Why you not like Gurren Lagann? Boa, do you want to explain that one or should I? You don't like it because it made you cry. Yelp. Exactly right, Boa. I also feel like all the characters got jilted on that one. Yes. Hush you. They pulled a Darling in the Franxx with that anime, alright? Yeah. See, Kamigama Kill and Kill la Kill, we knew what we were getting into, although I didn't know the plot hook in Kill la Kill. Kamigama Kill, though, like, when they started murdering people in, like, episode 2, I was like, oh, this is one where not, no one's really living in this one. Drillbur, the mole Pokemon.
Only one did.
Yeah. Akami. Yeah. Still sad, though. It can dig through the ground at speeds of 30 miles per hour. It could give a car running above ground a good race. Well, it was Simon Story. I know power. I know it was Simon Story. But I still felt he got done dirty, too. Like, I still feel like that everyone got done dirty. You there. No, you have black above your head. I know what that means. Okay, so I have that line already. Joltix! They're so cute! Dwilba, Dwilba. Joltik. Down deeper! We must go deeper. Oh my god, that's so cool. Look at the electrowebs! Fuck you. What does what mean, Power? Also, mine them. You, I need to catch. Come here. Get in the ball and stay, you little twerp. The thing about heaven. Oh, so if they've got the black speech bubble, they're supposed to be a harder fight. So like in the second DLC, the ones with the black speech bubble above their heads are part of the ogre clan. And they're like, they have items and they're really nasty. Like they actually have strategy to them. Minum, the cheering Pokemon. Exposure to electricity from Minum and Plusles promotes blood circulation and relaxes the muscles. So y'all are used in tandem for therapies. I sees. Electroweb. That's so cool. You find the Electroweb TM where there's a shit ton of Electrowebs all over the freaking walls.
He's in the goddamn walls.
Oh my god, there's so many. So Plusle's gonna be version exclusive to Violet then, isn't it? Instead of Scarlet. Hi, Dribbler. I did not mean to run into you, honey. Scatter before I murder you for health. No? They're both here? Ah! Okay. I just wasn't sure on that Joltik. I was like, that one looks a little bit bright. Also, hi, pup. Let's see. I still think the Electrowebs are cool. In a reunion circle with others, grind out barbecues. Fair enough. I'm not that far yet. Hey, Rotom made it back. So we'll continue to lurk. That's fine. Are you an orange core one? I haven't even done the first class yet. I got distracted. They let me run around unsupervised. It's not a me problem. Hush you. Well, you just agreed to become a health box. I just wanted to see if it was something other than the orange core. It's like the first thing you do after that. Ah, okay. You made it one step further than I did. Valid. First class is just catch a Alolan form. Ah, well. Flying Titan gives surf. Yup, sounds about right, Boa. It's a yellow core! It looks so goofy, but it's so weak. I love it. Well, lurkies for now, yup. Yes! Give surf. Yes, Boa, guess what? You don't really get fly, you get a glide, and that's usually the last Titan. Alright, so we have yellow, we have orange. I don't know if I have... I know I just caught the Elekid. I don't know why I ran into the Elekid. I was trying to run into the Electabuzz. We can catch the Electabuzz while we're down here. Or I can run into a Rotom that was at my ankles. Good. You've also already been caught. I can ignore you. Meow, meow, meow. Get in the ball, you angry thing. The ground titan flattened you? Yep. Sounds about right. Why do you know Giga Impact? Pretty much. Anyway. since you have to recharge, just give me that health, boy. Oh, it must recharge, you say. Get in the ball. That's what that. I just hear the Electabuzz screaming in the corner. Its body constantly discharges electricity. Getting close to it will make your hair stand on end. Do you still have to trade, like, Rhyperior and Electivire while they're holding their items to get them to evolve? Beak's done. Garvantula! Spooter! Spooter! Spooter!
Pickball!
Boom! Boom! Click! Burp-a-da-derp. Great Tusk should not be in an area much lower level than it. Yeah. It's just lull you into a false sense of security, Boa. The Ella Spider. They employ electrically charged webs to trap their prey. When it is immobilized by shock, they leisurely consume it. They don't even have to bite you. They just gotta get you in their webs. Okay, so riddle me this, gang. How the f*** do we get out of here? Now it's sped and one-shot your entire team. Yup! I love that electro web effect. Super slam, huh? Good. So many. You know what would be cool and terrifying is if you got stuck. Like if you touched the electro web and you got stuck to it. They just descend upon you in hordes, and you're like, oh god, death. Fletch Ender in chat. Whee! Yep. Mm-hmm. Gotta go fast! Ooh, one over here wants to be terrestrialized. Of course it's you. Well, luckily I don't need you, so. Whee! Fuck off. So many things are mad down here. Of course there's a Minum outbreak. Whee! Nope. My one complaint with the little dudes, the meteor guys, is the fact that they're all in their dormant state. So you can't tell what color they are until you battle them. Hello, Drillbirds. No, don't run into me, please. There's a reason I'm sprinting around like a lunatic. Oh, I can't climb the stone. I was hoping I could climb the sparky, sparky stone. Hello, Electros. I don't need you. I'm sorry to have disturbed you. It's not really a way up, is there? Because the walls are all too steep for me to climb up. Oh, maybe. Hang on. There we go. I need to ascend! Oh good, the outbreak is on the surface. Noted. Oh, there's the fossil. Come here, you. You might as well get in the bowl while we're here, too. Yes!
Yes!
Hey, girl, it's level 44. That girl was level 15 when we started this. It cheers on partners while scattering sparks from its body. It climbs telephone poles to absorb the electricity. Don't you guys also have a history of overloading yourselves? Ding! There we go. When in doubt, climb the rocks! Come on, Caridon. Thank you, bud. Ooh, desk balls. Yes, please. Beldum! How annoying. Wait, come here, you. I still have to capture you. And you I can't one-shot because you're terrestrialized. Do-do-do-do-do! Dance? You can dance if you wanna. You can dance if you try. Then, cat, I'm a kitty cat. I dance, 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 dance. Cat, I'm a kitty cat. I meow, 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 and I meow, meow, meow. Okay, there we go. Redemption, poor young cat. It is an artificial Pokemon. Since it doesn't breathe, people are excited by its potential to be useful within any environment. Eee. Whee! Bip. Dwilba. I'm just low-key trying to find my way out of here now. I do not yearn for the mines. Release me! Wait, what? How do I get out of here? Shit. Which is the branch that lets me out. Oh, I think it's this side. God, it's me getting lost in the chasm of Genshin all over again. Wait, didn't I just... God damn it. Brain, why you gotta be directionally challenged? How does one leave? Oop, hello. Metal outlet. I'm sorry, what was that? Metal alloy? I know of metal coat, but I've never heard of metal alloy. At least not in Pokemon. Waistband. Assuming it's in this grouping. Metal alloy. A particular metal that can make certain species of Pokemon evolve. Is this the new metal coat? Did they change the name of metal coat to metal alloy? Or is that how Duraludon evolves now? It's not metal coat, it's metal alloy in order to make him go bridge. That's probably what it is. I hate how you have to, like, pause on these. 126 from 1 hour, good lord. What? There's something else that's new? I only bought one item, though. Thought I saw it. Nope, okay. Let me see if I can teleport out of here. Okay, so an ability capsule. Upgrades, we can evolve. We can evolve again. Is that a safari ball? It's funny, I have Pokeghost Terra now stack. Nice. Anywho, map. Please, let me out of this cave. I'm tired of being stuck in the earth. Hey, now we fly around with Skarmory's. I gotta stretch your two senses together. You're fine, Boa. Alright, I guess it's time we go to the coastal. We've been running around for 2 hours. I cannot climb up the weird bricks. Noted. Hey, Picky Pecky. Alolan Grimer. Deerling. Execute. Hey, there's an Alolan Executor. Execute, the egg Pokemon. If you touch one of Execute's heads and while mistaking it for an egg, the other heads will quickly gather and attack you when it's within a swarm. It's giving the disembodied heads from Spirited Away. Schmeargle. Okay, Zangoose was in the original Pokedex for this game. I got an entire team's worth of level 60s in my Pokemon home, but my badge level is too low. Sounds about right. I don't know if you're gonna live a leech life, but we'll see. It does not. The spirit was like, I'm not getting caught, but I'm not. What? What, you? Get in the ball. Yes. Just hearing everything yell at me. They store toxins inside their bodies, so unlike Grimer from other regions, they don't even smell bad up close. Hang on, I see an item. Alright. Tentacool! Item! Ghost Terra Shard. This tropical area is a little bit more rocky than I thought it was gonna be. Maybe with Dig? What? Well, I found the sloths. I found all the sloths. Hey, look, another cave. Torchlit Labyrinth. How long before Wolf has to use Fly to get out of here, too? Ooh, what's this? Fire Pledge. It's a Alolan Diglett! Good job. Break it. I refuse to use the ladder like a normal human being. Grass Pledge. Interesting. There's a lot of Alolan Diglets. Where are you? Where am I? Ooh, rare bones. Monies! Oh no, okay. Ooh. So many Diglets. Galarian Slowpoke! You're just chilling, not a thought in those eyes. Let me out. Hey, we're back in the coastal biome. Noise. Inkay ink. Oh, how do we involve Inkays in this one? Because normally you flip level it up and you flip your console upside down. So do you have to take it off the dock and actually flip it upside down and level it up so it evolves? Or did they do something different? Oh god, it is not like the coastal area. Get in the ball, Inky. Thank you. Ba-ba-da-da. Inkay, the revolving Pokemon. It protects itself from tough foes by flashing its luminescent spots to discourage them. There's a Shininja in chat for anyone who wants one. Get the Wonder God bug. Man, it is not like the coastal area. My frames are stuttering hard now. No. Sorry, I thought the Finian was something else, and I was like, wait, what? So many Alolan Exeggutors, holy crap. There's a metal version of the bird. Alolan Muk! Odish! 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 Oh, did I run into the Picky Peck? I did. The little Bobby was hiding in the bush. Well, into the ball she go. Yes! Ba-da-ba. I'm sorry if it's weird that I'm catching everything. Yes, I have a living deck, so I could transfer everything into home. I don't want to do that, though. What is thump thumping? I mean, there's the middle form right there. Trumbeak, right, because it's Picky Peck Trumbeak 2 Cannon. No! Feather Dance. Well, that's a problem. Doo 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 doo. No, it's super effective. Leech life. I need help. Bullet seed. That's an interesting move for you to have.
Netball.
I will try to get the first lesson done, and then also we might have to save and call it for the night just because I did not sleep well last night. We would continue this sometime tomorrow, and then Sunday, if I've got enough people, we'll probably play Lethal Company again. Because here's the good thing. I did not, like, I haven't even officially started the Kitakami DLC on Violet yet, and because of that, I can kind of keep myself at bay on not doing this whenever I'm not streaming by doing Kitakami DLC on Violet. So I don't spoil anything for myself. Sorry, go muck.
Super potion.
So interesting, because I've got both forms, I wonder how you determine. Oh, there's another Milsri outbreak. If it evolves into like your execute, for example. There isn't different forms of execute for regular and Alolan. So how does it determine which version of Executor evolves into? Do you have to be in the coastal area if you want Alolan, and do you have to be like in the plains savanna for if you want regular? Or is it randomized? I wonder how that works. Schmeargle, come on. I love the fact that Smeargle's in this DLC because it means people are going to start using Smeargle possibly again in BGC, which I love because Smeargle is just chaos because of Sketch. That's a Tentacruel. I was like, what is bobbing under the water? Blossoms! I think that is one thing I do appreciate in the in Scarlet and Violet is the sheer number of fully evolved Pokemon you can just find in the wild. You don't always have to have the item. You don't always have to, you know, catch everything and level it up. Okay, as far as I know, we were supposed to go to the plaza, so I just want to do this. Was it not the plaza I was supposed to go to for a coastal for class? One 16, good lord. Good lordy. Alright, there we go. Map. Oh my god. We were so far off. I know Lacey's secret. Hello, Cottony. Yay.
Yeah, boy. Yes. Doop.
See, I'm also kind of excited because, like, I know we get to go deeper into Area Zero and all that, so I kind of want to, like, pay attention to the storyline, but at the same time, I'm just like, so much little things! Must explore everything. Yep. I'm gonna get distracted every time I see a light that says something sparkly, pick up this item. I definitely feel like, not the director of Blueberry, but the chick that we met in the Kitsukami one that was like the supervisor or whatever. I feel like she going to be evil because she was the one who's like, I must get into Area Zero and shit. I'm like, Briar. I don't trust Briar. Ooh, a dragon scale. Doo 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 doo. Well, Bell Blossom. Yeah, I can catch one real fast. I don't need a shiny honey though, because I already have this one as a shiny. Water type gym trainer with a clauncher is a pain. I mean, he's not that bad. Chasing after him to give him his wallet's a pain. Due to the effects of the sunstone, it is now active during the daytime and likes to dance in pools of sunlight. Interesting. I like the fact that it specifically tells you what item you needed to evolve it with. Alright, let's do our first class so I can, you know, actually get going on DLC. Oh, wolf. Not the lead... Either the trainer following him kept two shining your luck too. Ah, okay, I got you. You don't have any trade. It was fine. Yeah, we totally didn't have trouble. Glad to hear it. Aloha, everybody. Shall we get started? Or no, he said Alola instead of Aloha. Wait, what? Looks like we have a new face here with us today. I'm sure you're all enjoying the tropical climate that we've recreated here at the coastal biome. But remember, it's really ferment the many Pokemon you find living here, adapted for such weather. One such species has even grown exceptionally large than it might in other regions, thanks to all the light exposure here. That's right, certain species of Pokemon can have completely different appearances depending upon the region. We call this variation regional form. That brings us to today's tasks. Each of you, I'd like you to specifically catch a Pokemon, an Alolan form Pokemon. I've already got like three. Does it have to be in my party? Many classes of our classes here at the Blueberry Academy are practical ones like this. So off you go. Don't overthink it. Hey. Yes. Yes, my dude.
Oh God.
Not the Grimer. The muck. That's one, all right. This is a dangerous one. Those things that look like fangs and claws are actually crystallized poison. Touch one and it'll afflict you at once. Wait, well, you already finished the assignment. I was really motivated. So battling isn't your only talent, then. You've got a knack for catching Pokemon, too. Yep. Seems to see how high-level students must be. All right, everyone, gather around. We've run out of time for today, so that'll have to be class for the session. If you didn't manage to catch a Pokemon in time, I gave them 30 seconds. Man, really? I guess I'm stuck with homework. So what did you think of your first class? It was easy. My word, so the classes at your academy are even more demanding? What classes? Oh, I was supposed to make an appearance at the club room. Shoot. I'm afraid this will have to be the end of our little tour, but let me leave you with one more tip. Here at Blueberry, we have lots of extracurricular tasks you can take on called Blueberry Quests, or just BBQs for short. They're sort of like missions the school assigns to students out and about and in the terrarium. You might be asked to have your Pokemon do some auto battles or to catch specific Pokemon, those sorts of things. You never know what the next BBQ might be or what you'll need to do to carry it out. But if you can do what's asked of you, you'll earn Blueberry Points. BP is kind of a school currency you can use at the cafeteria and the store. You might be able to use it for club activities in the future too. Anyway, the long and short of it is that you should do BBQs to get yourself BB. Okay. Max, the 3 quests will be displayed by default. Each time you complete a quest, a new one will take place, and every time you clear 10 quests, a bonus quest will be unlocked. You can also help your friends with their quests. Everyone who took part will receive BP rewards with that quest, so work together and clear as many as you can. Okay, cool. I will probably honestly grind those out off stream and just grind out a ton of them. Hey kid, take 50k, win the auction for me. Yup. Carmine, this is Wolfstone, right? It's me, Carmine. I heard the news. You got picked for the Blueberry Academy's exchange program, correct? Yup. Look at that little Blitzel! One of my teachers told me, never thought we'd be fellow students of BB Academy. Anyway, you should totally show your face. It's been too long already. Now let me think, where should we meet up? Oh, have you been to the terrarium? There's a space called the Central Plaza right in the center of the dome. I'll meet you there. Don't keep me waiting if you know what's good for you. Mild Mint Wolf. What's up, pup? Keep her waiting. Why? I want a union. I'm going to have to save the union stuff for next time, pup. Because honestly, I'm probably going to hop off soon. Hello, you. I saw you hiding there. I know, but it's literally the fact that I did not sleep last night. I need sleeps. You're boring. I know. Catch you later, Wolf. Catch you later, Boa. Thanks for chilling. Aw, I didn't live. Sadness. God damn it. Vigoroth, I didn't mean to run into you. Leave me alone. Yeah, it would be Sunday around noon. Because it would be definitely you, Pogue, myself. I don't know if we would have a fourth or not. So I can post it in the Lethal Company and see if anyone's up for it. Hey, a 2 cannon. Cannon! Casual, get your butt hit in here on today. Casual got a new job, so I don't know what his schedule currently is, Boa. It's so weird to me that y'all have bullet seed. Also, this is doing nothing. Do you live a leech life? Yes. Yes, you do. Whoa! I will say, other than being in the water and occasionally it's struggle bussing, it's doing a lot better than it has been for frame rates.
You used a netball. Shaky. You bastard.
Ow. I guess I can try an Ultra Ball. I was low-key hoping it was going to use Drill Run again and get freaking burned. Oh, I don't have Mighty in the party right now, so I don't have Yawn either. Damn it. That's about the only move I have on my party that inflicts a status condition. Which we might see this team change up a bit just because they do focus on double battles here, and this team is not very double battle friendly per se. So you may see me switch out the team a little bit. I'm gonna try Leech Life. I'm assuming you're gonna die to it though. Oh no! You didn't. Oh, because you're lowering my attack, that's why. I forgot you used Feather Dance. Well, that means we're gonna live this one too. Perfect. I mean, you can keep spamming the Bullet Seed. It doesn't do much in the grand scheme of things. You're doing 3 a hit. I would appreciate it, though, if you stopped getting 4s and 5s. Alright. Please, Toucannon, get in the ball and stay, pretty bird. Polly, want a cracker? Yeah, there we go. Da-da-da. Complete? What? What? I'm gonna randomly be doing quests, aren't I, and not realize it. Travel over 500. Defeat 10 Pokemon while using. Take a photo of all Pokemon swimming. I don't do photos, though. There's so many Terra Shards just laying on the ground in here. It's weird. Why are there so many Terra Shards? Are they falling from the roof? Hello. Oddish! Oddish, Oddish. Gloom. Hey, there we go. Hey, I see a Whimsicott. It just fell off the edge. 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 Pick up 10 items. Well, that's easy for me. Successfully sneak up on one Pokemon and surprise them with a battle. Does that count? Don't mind me as I just set the entire area on fire. Apparently that doesn't count. Oh, can I not like throw my Pokeball at them? Do I have to like sneak up and touch them? They definitely aren't aware of me. Touch. If that didn't count, I'll try again with something else because they may have turned around at the last second. What else do we got? Okay, 10 items on the ground. We'll do that real quick and then we'll try sneaking up on something. That's an oddish. I was like, I saw a blue, what is that? Item? Item! You, come here real quick. And I'm going to murder your children. Please stay in the quick ball. As soon as I get there. Yeah, boy. You didn't do the thing. Sadness. Guys, we found another cave. Tentacool stinger. It's so weird when they flash the lights because it keeps catching my attention. But we found a cave. Oh, it's part of the torchlit labyrinth. Okay. Oh, we've come out this cave before. Okay, cool. I know where this is. Bottle cap. Seven. Oh my god, the Hapinis. Okay, so these quests to grind out aren't that bad. Damn it, I landed on the Hapini. Let's try not to land on the baby. Coastal biome. Is that? It's a shiny Sviper! Let's go! I don't have that one yet. At least I don't think I do. I'll have to check my Pokedex, but... I was like, that one looked wrong. It's because it was a shiny. Let's go, first full-on shiny. Kill it? No. I got it. Do you have a mark? No. I am going to clip again because I might have hit that prematurely because it goes back 10 seconds. Okay. Before I hit the dex button, let me check my dex tracker for Sviper real quick. I don't think I have that one shiny. I know I don't have Zangoose. Let's see. Scroll down to Gen 3. Danger of Blissey, there's Entei. Okay. So now I'm at Gen 3. Seviper. Nope, I didn't have it. Cool. Dex. Okay. That's fine. Cool. That one was a new one. Not bad, though. First flawed shiny. I'm really glad I was like, wait, I don't trust the shadow. None of those have a pink flower. Lunge. Oh, little healing stations. Soul's book. Hello, Flygon. Please stay in the quick ball. There we go. Funny enough, when it comes to Trapinch line, the only one I'm missing the shiny of is, what is it? Verbrava, the middle one. I have shiny Flygon and I have shiny Trapinch, but not the Verbrava. Boop. Come on, step on top of the rock. Oh, Magnemizer, okay. Yeah, come here, Trapinch. Go ahead and catch you for the Dex real fast. Meow. What lit, Leo? Let's go. Meow. Ooh, Sandile in chat. Boop. What did I just run into? Oh, there's another Trapinch there. I was like, what did I run into? Trapinch. Meow. Swear Lit Leo's, I'm just a baby. Which I'm surprised I haven't found a shiny Lit Leo or a Pyroar in this game yet, because as many times I've been up and down the mountains where they spawn and friggin' their little groups. But then again, the first time this game ever spawns a Seviper for me, it's friggin' shiny, so there's that. Oh no, it wouldn't have been the first, because I forgot, Seviper's in the base game too. It's not new to the DLC. Let's see, give me a decent set of spawns to KO. Mammal Soil, let's put you up front. Go murder! When in doubt, have it murder. Murder. You keep murdering until the game says stop. All right, 10 more ground items. Should be easy. Amanda Buzz. Catch a Pokemon. Well, come here, new Pokedex entry. Oh, I was really hoping for the critical capture there. Ow. This is gonna kill you, but... I was really hoping it had Sturdy. Rhyhorn. Oh god. Okay. Oof. It does not like this area either. There's a couple areas, man, where you feel the lag spikes. That's cool, they're drinking their little sandpit traps. Where's a Pokemon that's easy to catch for the Dex? Hello, Graveler. Alright, well, I guess we chose Geodude. Critical capture, I'll take it. Bum-ba-da-da! To the box it goes. Boop. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Hello, come here. Need you for the Dex. Please stay. Damn it. Wonder Room, okay. Twist it back. I don't know what's under the ground crying, but I just see the little tears from it. Okay, I don't think I have anything special for you, so regular Ultra Ball it is. No! Man, I really should put my Anna in the party for Yawn. Come on, man, please stay. Ah, don't be a tease. Yeah, future side attack. Dodged. Alright, Mammal Swine, I didn't realize you could dodge a future sight psychic type attack, but alright. There we go. Cool, that finishes that line. Well, I can see the charge cave underneath. Multiplying Pokemon. Interesting. Does it still have two brains? So you guys spawn more towards evening slash nighttime. Okay. Yeah, I just said, but lucky you didn't spawn the first time I was over here, which is entirely possible. Ghost Terra Shards. So many Terra Shards, man. Catch Pokemon. Well, I don't need to catch anything over here right now. Unless you spawn something else I haven't caught yet for the Dex. But it doesn't look like it. Wait, Smeargle. Still have yet to catch the Smeargle. It keeps choosing suicide. One of these days, you'll stay in the Quick Ball. Travel over 500 yards, bet. And we got the Smeargle finally. It was like, what, the fourth attempt at catching Smeargle? I'd say we're doing really well when it comes to this Pokedex so far. Right here, wrong button. 125 so far. We've seen 134. I can't be mad at these numbers. We started at 88. Nope. Right. I guess, hand me the Safari Ball. Electrolyzer is a Pokedex reward. Interesting. Because we had found the other evolutionary items for like Magmortar and all them, but not the Electrolyzer yet. So I don't know if that means that we can find it on the map or the only way is your Pokedex. All right. So I guess we're just gonna run around for a second until we hit. Battle a wild Terra Pokemon. Can find it on the map. Okay, cool. So I gotta go find a Terra spawn real quick. Guy, I'm in union with, found Electrolyzer on the map. Found the Magmizer. Yeah, see, I'd found Magma. I'd found the Assault Vest. The Electrolyzer was the only one that I hadn't found yet. Oh, and technically the Reaper Cloth for Duskanor. So it doesn't mean Terra Raid, it means like an actual Terra, wild Terra Pokemon, right? You can't do the silent dot dot dot. You're not red. Imposter. I thought there was one around here. Because the only one I did was the Porygon in the cave, so all the other ones should still be around here. Please don't. I said should. I don't know if they despawn or at random. Oh god, what did I land on? Oh, a horsey. I just want to find the Terra and we'll probably call it... Good. I feel like all of these will eventually lead into Charged Stone Cave. Ah, there's the Rhydon. Perfect. Come here. Oh, you just have to battle it. You don't even have to defeat it. Okay. You're a water type now, buddy. Rawr. Mega Horn. I mean, it's not the one hit KO moves, therefore we don't care. I'm gonna finish you off with Ice Fang at a spite. And just like that, you're no longer a water type.
Die.
Technically, I probably should have caught it, but I mean, it's fine. There'll be other Rhydons. Growlithe, you're almost level 50. Hi there. Taking care of a good number of those BBQs. Up until now, you've only had access to entry level stuff. Seeing as how you handled that, I think it's time to give you access to regular quests. Okay, those are still regular. I guess it has to rotate them. Okay. How the fudge do you take pictures again? I don't remember. Is it down? Not that. Yeah, it's down. Because the mode is up. Oh my god. I don't do the camera thing, alright? Cool. Make yourself a TM. No. Take a photo of a wild Pokemon in Savannah biome. That means I gotta go back to Savannah biome. Schmeargle. Trying to remember which side the Savannah biome's on. Oh, well. Come on. Come on. There you go. Climb up top. Is that... No. No, okay. I thought the one next to it that's running away was the shiny, and I was like, ain't no way. There's no way I walk up and there's already one waiting. It's just that low light. Nope. Although noted, the terror raids can also have them fully evolved. I'm not gonna lie, I don't like this spot for them spawning. Because they're spawning like everywhere, and I feel like they're spawning in the walls. So I don't like how they're spawning, they're spreading out. This is not shiny, is it? No. Why were you freaking out about it? It's fine. Like, well, Corona, I don't understand on that one, hon. You can fly. Like, it's not like you couldn't get to it. Whatever. Alright. I'm honestly probably gonna save it here. Savannah biome, okay. Wait, what was the other one? Make yourself a TM, right. Defeat 10 Pokemon using auto battle. Well, can't wreck right on here, my ass. Watch me. It's already starting to go down. Jesus. You didn't murder that many of them. Look, if it tells me to murder auto battle wise, I'm just like, ah, I'm just gonna murder 10 into the mill series real fast. I thought I was gonna get some different ones, damn it. Or is it one of those things that they're not gonna do that until you save and relaunch the game type shite? Yeah, I don't like trying to spot these guys at night. It's a little bit more difficult. Yeah. It's really hard until you're like on top of them, and then you can see the tint of yellow. Instead of like, is it what? Which I'm trying to look at the eyes for that darker gray, but eh. At least the Growlithe hit level 50. Yeah, none of you guys are a shiny. Nope. Alright, well, while this is murdering, I'm gonna go see if we can't find someone to raid to. I know there's only a few of us, but hey. We'll see if any of our friends are online. Wait. Wait, what, pup? I mean, I was just gonna raid into Sarcastic Jacob. That's just because there's not a lot of us tonight. There you go. Murder these down here. I mean, yeah, you can. Why did you kill a Turtwig in their face? Are starters rare spawns or something? I wouldn't be surprised. None of you guys. Reasons? Pop. What? You're like, you can catch it, and I slowly approached it and used auto battle. Oh my gosh, pup. Why would you do that? My shiny Eldrawn was in lead, so I accidentally spoiled that. Ah. I still think we're gonna go over to Jacob, because it looks like Jacob's just doing shiny hunting anyway. I don't know how much longer Jacob's gonna be live, though, because Jacob's been live for 5 hours. So give him some love, and I will catch you guys tomorrow for more DLC. Tomorrow, what time? Probably around the same time as this, if not a little bit earlier. We are going to go to a Christmas market tomorrow. So, I will post in the Discord before I go live. So, but I will catch you guys later, okay? Please remember, drink food, eat water. God damn it. Drink water, eat food, stretch if you can. Tomorrow, Union? Yeah, we can do the Union stuff tomorrow, pup. That's not a problem. I will see y'all later. Be nice for Jacob.